Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Once again, good morning. And so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, and deed, so we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say a prayer for an increase of the Polish National Catholic Church. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I lack. In green pastures you let me graze. To safe waters you lead me. You restore my strength. You guide me along the right path for the sake of your name. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
As this is a solemnity, we will stand and say the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, you called a humble priest Father Francis Hodor, to be your servant and to awaken your people for work in your vineyard. Grant that, as we observe the anniversary of your call to us, our faith may be made firm and our hearts may be enkindled by the fire of sacrificial love. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Then shall the righteous one with the great assurance confront his oppressors, who set as naught his labors. Seeing this, the wicked shall be shaken with dreadful fear and be amazed at the unexpected salvation. They shall say among themselves, rueful and groaning through anguish of spirit. This is one whom once we held a laughingstock and as a type for mockery, fools that they were. His life we accounted madness and death dishonored. See how he is accounted among the heavenly beings. Now his lot is with the holy ones. This is the word of the Lord. Please respond. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice before him with trembling. Pay homage to him. I will praise you, Lord, with all my heart. I will recount all your wonders. I will rejoice in you and be glad and sing psalms to your name, O Most High. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice before him. With trembling, pay homage to him. See how my enemies turn back, how they stumble and perish before you. You have checked the nations, destroyed the wicked. You have wiped out their name forever and ever. With trembling, pay homage to him. The nation's feet have been caught in the snare they laid, for the needy shall not always be forgotten, nor the hopes of the poor be in vain.
The second reading is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Timothy. Now the Spirit explicitly says that in the last times some will turn away from the faith by paying attention to deceitful spirits and demonic instructions through the hypocrisy of liars with branded consciences. They forbid marriage and require abstinence from foods that God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. For everything created by God is good, and nothing is to be rejected when received with thanksgiving, for it is made holy by the invocation of God in prayer. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that
that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. This is the gospel of the Lord.
If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, 124 years ago this week, a young priest who was brought to Scranton from Nanticoke, Pennsylvania, celebrated Mass for the first time on the site of what is now St. Stanislaus Bishop and Martyr Cathedral. That act was an act of defiance. In celebrating that Mass for a group of Polish immigrants who were disaffected by their Irish bishop in Scranton, he incurred excommunication from the Roman Catholic Church. Once he received that letter, he set it on fire and threw it into the river behind the church. But that, my brothers and sisters, is how our church was organized. In the late 19th century, in places like Chicago, Buffalo, Detroit, Scranton, various independent movements were coming up because of the oppression of the Roman Catholic bishops on the immigrants from Poland. They weren't allowed to keep their customs or anything like that. And in 1897 began the unification of these independent parishes into one whole that we have today. And we, so many over a century hence, are the inheritors of this. And we still play a role. Not all of us are Polish. We don't have to be. You don't have to be from Italy to be Roman Catholic, right? We have expanded, but our mission has remained the same. We continue the unbroken line of succession from the apostles, starting with St. Peter and St. John and so forth, all the way to today through the laying on of hands of the priests. Bishop Holder even continued that, becoming ordained a bishop in Utrecht, Holland. And we believe in everything that has always and everywhere been taught as Catholic. We rejected the novelties that came in the 19th and 20th centuries from our brothers and sisters in Rome. We rejected the primacy and supremacy of the Bishop of Rome. We have clergy who are allowed to participate in all the sacraments and are not barred from one, namely marriage. But most importantly, we realize in such an acute way that all of us together are the church. We all have a role to play. Everyone here has ownership in this parish. Everyone. That's unique. That's unique in the Catholic world. And we come together on Sundays, even sometimes on weekdays, to worship the one true God, his Son Jesus Christ, with the unity of the Holy Spirit in the Trinity, in the fullness of the Godhead revealed to us and passed down through the centuries. We owe a very great debt of thanks to Prime Bishop Francis Hodder for that one act of defiance he did back in March of 1897. Because without him, we would not be sitting here today, and we would not have the freedom to worship that we have today in a way that God intended, in the way that was passed down unadulterated from the apostles. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed we share with the undivided church. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Confident that our loving Father will hear and answer the prayers we offer, let us turn to him now with our petitions. Our response is, Lord, have mercy.
For the Polish National Catholic Church, that she may continue to teach all to live in the light of Christ and to celebrate the great truth of God's self-giving love on this 124th anniversary of institution, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who hold public office, that they will imitate the goodness of God who secures justice and the rights of all the oppressed and the most vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our families, that through the intercession of Saint Joseph, glory of domestic life, we may be inspired to make our homes places of formation in faith and prayer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, that they may be surrounded by God's grace and healing love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the intention of this holy mass, Prime Bishop Francis Hodder, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our departed loved ones and those who will die today, that they may share in the gift and promise of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Loving Father, you who are rich in mercy, because of your great love for us, brought us to life with Christ, even when we were dead in our transgressions. We ask you to hear these and all of our prayers, both spoken and unspoken, as we live by that life. We ask all these things through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Mighty your arm, strong your hand, is ever exalted. Justice and judgment are the foundation of your throne. Love and loyalty march before you. Happy the people who know you, Lord, who walk in the radiance of your face. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. May it become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. May it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless this sacrifice which we have prepared for the glory of your holy name. O Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, Most Holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, and Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Accept this sacrifice from my hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of his holy church.
Loving Father, as we place these gifts before you, grant us faith, integrity, and patience as we labor to build your holy church. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. We praise you and celebrate your calling forth of the Polish National Catholic Church, through which you call us to carry the light of Christ to all people. Through word and sacrament, we encounter Christ and receive your grace to bring the Church to its full stature as the true teacher of human society, destined to reach its perfection in heaven. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Holy. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 2, which is found on page 82. We give thanks to you, God our Father, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, whom in these last days you have sent us as Savior, Redeemer, and Messenger of your will. He is your Word, inseparable from you. Through him you have made all things, and in him you were well pleased. You sent him from heaven to a virgin's womb. There he dwelt and was made flesh. He was revealed as your Son, born through the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin. When he suffered, he fulfilled your will and gained for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands to free from suffering those who believed in you. When he was betrayed to his freely chosen suffering, thereby to destroy death, to break the chains of darkness, to crush hell beneath his feet, to give light to the just, to make a covenant, and to manifest his resurrection. He took bread. He gave you thanks and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." In like manner, he took the cup and said, "This is my blood, which is poured out for you. Whenever you do this, do it in memory of me." Together, calling then his death and resurrection to mind, we offer you the bread and the cup. We thank you for allowing us to come before you and to serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church, to gather all in unity. Grant to all who partake of these holy mysteries the fullness of the Holy Spirit for the strengthening of their faith in the truth. So may we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him may glory and honor be yours, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, now and forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father,
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, forever and ever.
The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Because there is one bread, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. On the solemnity of the institution, let us offer a sign of peace via a high hello or a fist or an elbow bump. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Let us say together the Second Communion prayer on page 98. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment or condemnation, though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, for your loving kindness, may it become my safeguard and healing remedy. My saving master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite me entirely with you, my Lord and my God. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. Behold, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord.
Thank you.
us from pure heart that which I've taken this food and I give to every seed bring humans right now for. As the Father has loved me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, our merciful Father, grant that, as we benefit from the grace received in this holy sacrament, we may follow your holy will, as we continue to build your holy church. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael on page 4 of the bulletin. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace in our world, country, state, and localities with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. And seeing as I neglected the act of spiritual communion at the proper time for those online and those who are with us here that chose not to receive today, we say together the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I thank you so much for joining us today, especially with the valiant effort of it being technically an hour earlier today. So congratulations on making it. I congratulate myself too. Hope that you'll join us for some weekday masses this week, Monday through Thursday at noon Central Daylight Time, and next Sunday at 9 a.m. Central Daylight Time. May God bless each and every one of you. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care of each other, and always remain in a state of grace.